It's day five of the swimming competition at the Chengdu 2021 FISU World University Games. As we welcome you to the Dong'an Lake Sports Park Aquatic Center, this is the medals session. Well, the host nation China has certainly dominated the opening 4 days of competition. They've won 9 of the 22 golds on offer so far, and they're expecting further success in the pool this session. The medal session on day five, though, begins with the men's 800-meter freestyle final. A field featuring 5 swimmers who've already medaled in distance events here, including all 3 on the podium. After the 1,500-meter freestyle, only 4 countries represented in this final: Brazil, Italy, Japan, and USA. Getting away very nicely was Lamberti in lane 4 out of University of Brescia, the 24-year-old. Going quickly, though, in lane 5 is Tabucci. So the swimmers will be looking to get out in a decent time and then settle into relatively even 50-meter splits. That'll be the plan from the respective swimmers and their coaches. But Tabucci's gone out relatively hard, and Kurokawa, his compatriot alongside him in 6, look to be the top 2 through the opening 50 meters. They've gone out in 26.57, but it is Tabucci and Kurokawa ahead of Lamberti. He won't be worried about his position in the pool just yet. What he will worry about is how quickly he settles into his rhythm, how quickly he settles into his tempo. Some swimmers like to go out hard, like to break up the field, like to lead from the front. And Tabucci is going to touch first at the 100 mark, 55.75 through 100 meters. Jack Hoagland within a second and a half. So Tabucci and Kurokawa alongside one another in lanes 5 and 6. But don't discount Matteo Lamberti. He's also quick in the back end of a race if needs be. He's got the ability to change gears and does prefer swimming the 400 and 800 meter events. There are swimmers in this pool that have done the 1.5 and are hoping to medal in the 800 as well. Now, bear in mind, things have changed in recent years now that swimmers can compete in both the 800 events and 1,500 meter events at major meets. Previously, it was just the 1,500 meter freestyle for men and 800 meter freestyle for women. It now features 800 and 1,500 meter freestyle events for both men and women. And that doesn't allow the athletes to focus solely on one race and then their recovery. So between events, it's so important from a nutrition perspective, from a sleep perspective, from a training perspective, to make sure that they can give their best for both events. And all 3 swimmers on the podium in the 1,500 meter freestyle find themselves in this final. Nagy going in 1 for USA, the bronze medalist, the silver medalist, Tabucci leading at the moment. And Giovannoni, not out of it, going in lane 7, the gold medalist in the 1.5. Tabucci ahead of Lamberti, ahead of Kurokawa. Kurokawa is just falling a little off the pace. He's around 2 seconds back of Tabucci. Giovannoni is making a little bit of a move and coming up on the outside of Kurokawa. This is the halfway mark. They're coming up to the 400 meter, 3:55.93. We're set to see a race go sub 8 minutes. Tabucci ahead of Lamberti, and Kurokawa now nearly 3 seconds down. And Giovannoni making up ground on him. The Brazilian going in 3, 400 free silver medalist also. Just a little intensity to his swim, just upping the tempo ever so slightly. But watch Lamberti. He's closing the gap. He finds himself making up ground on Tabucci, who leads. Now under a second separate the top 2. And Kurokawa falls further back. And he's just about being caught by Giovannoni, who will move into the bronze medal position. The battle for gold, though, is going to be an intense one, you get the sense. Because Lamberti and Tabucci are swimming not quite side by side. But Lamberti is virtually up on the shoulder of Tabucci and is posting quicker splits over his 50 meters. Every length of the pool, he is eating away at Tabucci's lead. 0.06 of a second separate them now. Watch the breathing pattern of Lamberti. He looks so elegant. That high elbow, lovely stroke, good kick rate as well. not too intense. Looking at a two-beat kick. He'll up that to a four-beat kick and potentially six-beat kick in the closing stages. And what he's done is he's almost started to race a 400-meter freestyle now in the pool for an 800-meter. And he's got that speed. He is the fastest in the field. And he's looking to prove that with his efforts in the water. Giovannoni has moved into third now. And Italy are looking well-placed for a couple of medalists. Lamberti leads, Giovannoni third. Tabucci of Japan, out of Meiji University in the capital city, Tokyo. A 7.54 swimmer at his best, but he's got some work to do if he's to catch Lamberti, who's not slowing down. The second longest event in the pool, the 800-meter freestyle. The race often broken down into smaller chunks by the swimmers. And for Lamberti, that may prove to be an advantage. It wasn't about going out as fast as he could. It was about going at the fastest pace he could hold on to for a significant distance. And now he leads by nearly a second and a half. It's not that Tabucci and Giovannoni are going slower. Lamberti is simply going faster. And the Italian is showing his prowess, his ability. The 400-meter freestyle gold medalist takes the bell, 100 meters to go. Looking to become a double champion at Chengdu 2021. His father, Giorgio, one of the greats of Italian swimming. His father was the first Italian to win a world championship title. Former world record holder in the 200-meter freestyle. He comes from good stock. He and his brother Michele, both medalists at these championships. With 50 meters to go, Lamberti is on for a decent time here. He's ahead of Tabucci by 2.5 seconds. Giovannoni looks settled into that third spot in the pool. Tabucci went out hard, led for 500 meters, but Lamberti is the man who's going to touch first. He's absolutely cruising, he's upped his kick rate, but he's going to glide to the wall in a very comfortable time. Matteo Lamberti wins in 7.54.12, 7.57.37 for Tabucci, who touches to claim the silver medal, and Giovannoni with a fine bronze makes him a multiple medalist at these games after winning the 1,500 meter free. Again, Italy have two swimmers on the podium. Lamberti, gold. Giovannoni, bronze. From the University of Brescia. Both he and his brother swimming to represent their educational institute. Timed his strokes so well. His breathing patterns were excellent. The elbow, the breathing on point. Giovannoni, 8 minutes dead for third. Tabucci second, 7.57. And a 7.54 for Matteo Lamberti. Confirming the medalists, Italy 1 and 3, as Giovannoni, the 1-5 champion, takes bronze. Silver medal to Tabucci Kaito, who led for 500 meters, but Matteo Lamberti has done the 400 and 800 double. He's champion of the men's 800-meter freestyle. One of the highlights of the evening is the women's 200-meter breaststroke final. There's the start list. Tatarevkova was quickest out over the 100, but this is Corbett's preferred distance. Olga Young, Ju, Corbett, Tetarevkova, Fischer, Cheng, and Ferragutti getting away in this women's 200-meter breaststroke final. Good reaction time from Kayleen Corbett, and she got away very nicely. Tetarevkova up alongside her. Slightly faster stroke rate and tempo for Kayleen Corbett in the opening 50, and she's in front at the moment with Tetarevkova alongside her. The importance of breathing and getting a rhythm with your breath is so vital when it comes to the breaststroke. The basics, pull, kick, glide. The kick needs to be perfect. Corbett touches 0.09 of a second ahead of Teterevkov out the wall. Zhu for China is third, just a little under half a second back. The three are starting to pull away from those around them and looking to settle into the medal positions here. The battle between Corbett, who leads only just from Teterevkova, is an intense one. 32.88 for Corbett going out. Can she hold on over the back 100 as well? Looks like she might just get to the wall first. It depends on who's going to be caught between strokes. A little glide to the wall from Corbett. Teterevkova with half a stroke touches first, separated by 0.06 of a second. Zhu remains in third, but she's now over a second down on the other two, who continue to battle it out for this gold. The 100-meter breaststroke title was won by Teterevkova as she beat Corbett. Teterevkova is quicker over this distance, a 2:22.88 from her at her best. Corbett at 2:23, but she trains with the Olympic champion Tatiana Schoenmaker at the University of Pretoria. The University of Pretoria, the home of South Africa's high-performance center. At the moment, it is Teterevkova only just ahead of Corbett at the wall. They're separated by a 10th of a second. Much depends on the turn. They are now matching each other in terms of stroke, and trying to pick up the pace is Corbett. She knows it's a now-or-never situation. Teterevkova, too, is looking to up the pace, up the intensity. Her breathing looks better. Her rhythm looks better. She's got the chin tucked in very nicely. Don't worry about the time. They're not going to break the FISU record. The battle between these two swimmers has been intense, and it looks like the Lithuanian is going to come out on top for the second successive breaststroke race. Teterevkova and Corbett, who's coming back in the closing meters. Is it going to be Lithuania in front of Corbett of South Africa? Teterevkova takes it and does the double, 100 and 200. Zhu of China touches third, but some way back. 2:28.71 for third. Corbett and Teterevkova well ahead of the field. They pushed one another. 2:22.86. Personal best that Teterevkova was able to swim, and she needed to post something really quick to claim that gold medal. Pushed all the way by Kaylin Corbett, who dips under 2:23 for the first time in her career as well. Great swim, wonderful competition in a race that requires great mental toughness. The impact on the body, on the mind, can't be overstated, but that's what it means. Teterevkova, champion in the women's 200-meter breaststroke. She's done the 100 and 200-meter breaststroke double, and she beats Kaylin Corbett again. Zhu of China takes the bronze in a very fine battle between herself and Cheng. Now to one of the marquee events in the pool, the men's 100-meter freestyle final. Pedro Henrique Silva Spaggiari, the 26-year-old from São Paulo, will be among the favorites for the gold medal here. Duncan, Armbruster, Hovanyek, Spaggiari, Siranska, Peixoto, Mizohata, Carraro. Great start in lane 8 for Carraro of Italy. Great reaction time as well from Hovanyek of Poland going in 3. Good underwater from the man in 2, Armbruster of Germany, who looks to be just in front coming up to the 25-meter mark, but into his stroke by Spaggiari looks impressive. He competed back at the 2017 FISU World University Games and still going strong is the 26-year-old out of São Paulo, and he's first at the wall, 0.18 of a second ahead of Carraro with Saratsky of Poland. 0.21 of a second back. Not much separating the top five at the moment. Very little separating the swimmers in the pool. Hovanyek touched fifth, and he was 23.74 out. Going well in lane 8 is Carraro of Italy. He went out in 23.60, touched second at the wall. Coming into his own now is Siratsky in 5. The double gold medalist here. He won the 200 free. He's hoping to touch first. He does indeed touch first ahead of Carraro. We have a dead heat for third. 49.08 for Siratsky. It's not sub 49, but Siratsky has 3 gold medals, and he's done the double. 49.34, the bronze will be shared by Peixoto and Hovanyek. Ms. Hovanyek picks up an individual medal as well in the pool. Wonderful control of the race from Siratsky, though. A very measured 23.63 out, 49.08 the winning time from Kamil Siratsky, his third gold medal Carraro takes a fine silver from lane 8, and Martins and Hovaniek share bronze. Now time for one of the highlights of not only the evening session, but indeed Chengdu 2021 in the pool. It's the women's 100-meter butterfly final. The excitement about this race is that it features the world champion, Zhang Yufei of People's Republic of China. Petrovsky, Hiroshita, Dinichenzo, Zhang, Gallagher, Jing, Scotto and Sebastian. Getting away nicely in lane 4 was Zhang. Dinichenzo got away for Italy nicely and into a stroke quickly is Gallagher of South Africa, but she's already a little down on Zhang Yufei. Great reaction time from the Chinese superstar who first shot to prominence at the Nanjing Youth Olympic Games, where she won 6 medals, including 4 golds as well. And she is continuing to dominate here. She dominated in the women's 50 fly and in the 100 free. She won them both in championship record time. Unsurprisingly, it's Zhang who touches first at the 50 ahead of Aaron Gallagher. 0.83 seconds behind. Hiroshita of Japan is currently tucked into third. Zhang Yufei is controlling this race. She's not going all out, but she's taken it out fairly quickly. A 26.06. One wonders how close she is going to be coming home to breaking the Visu record. She's well ahead of it at the moment. At 26.06, though, was quick going out. Sarah Sjöström setting the world record. We're now in 26.01. It's going to be 1-2 for the favorite, Zhang Yufei, in Visu record time ahead of Aaron Gallagher. Dinichenzo claims an individual medal in the pool, and she finishes third. But Zhang Yufei, 56.57. It's a Fizu record. By over a second, she obliterates Catherine Savard's record that has stood for 10 years. And true to form, another championship record for Zhang. Aaron Gallagher delighted with her silver, and Giulia Dinichenzo, after 2 relay medals, an individual medal for the student at University of Rome, La Sapienza. The 58.33 for Dinichenzo, but well out in front, Zhang Yufei. Beautiful technique, spectacular speed, out in 26.06. That's just 0.05 seconds off Sjöström's split in the world record that she set, that 55.48. Aaron Gallagher, 57.64. That's a new Africa record. She's broken Farida Osman's Africa record. Dinichenzo with a brilliant bronze. This is the first time that the mixed 4x100 freestyle relay is being contested at the FISU World University Games. So we will see an inaugural champion crowned in the next few minutes. Switzerland, China, Japan, Brazil, Italy, Poland, USA, South Africa. The final event on day 5 of competition is underway. It's the mixed 4x100-meter freestyle relay. And Poland are looking really solid in relays. Going very nicely in lane 6, Poland. Italy is looking quick, and so too Brazil alongside them. Going nicely in lane 2 is People's Republic of China through the strong fly swimmer Chen Junner. Italy touch ahead of China, Poland in 3rd at the moment. The top 4, not too much separating them, and indeed this is about building an advantage if you can, courtesy of your male swimmers nice and early, and then getting your female swimmers in the pool. The times obviously will be slower, but it's down to how significant the lead is. China will close with Zhang Yufei. So China ahead of Italy, ahead of Poland is how things stand in the pool at the moment. China have got Lin Tao in the pool. Japan through Yanimoto, Martins in the pool for Brazil, Carraro in the pool for Italy, Siradzki looking for another gold medal. He's picked up the 100-meter freestyle title already for Poland tonight, just off the pace. China touched first, over half a second ahead of Brazil. Within a second of China, though, is Italy, who touched third as Carraro looks to race back to the wall. Dahlgren of USA is looking to give Mostek and Tang something to work with. Gusk and Fitkiewicz will be in the pool for Poland as well. South Africa look out of it after Ross and Van Rienen. Gallagher will come. She'll make up some ground for South Africa. But it is going to be People's Republic of China who are second after a brilliant swim from Bruno Martins Correa. Brings Brazil in front at the halfway mark. Now into the female swimmers, Italy currently in third, but Biagioli is in the pool and Gastaldi will finish. So there's some speed. Li Pingji has already decimated the advantage that was held And China are in front, coming up toward the mark at 250. It'll be Italy just behind Brazil. Within half a second of one another are the top three. Too much for Anya Mostek to do, and a little too much for Japan to do as well, I suspect. But China, through Li Bingjin, no more for a distance racing, but already a multiple medalist. Four gold medals in the pool at Chengdu 2021. She's in the pool, and Zhang Yufei is looking for seven gold medals in seven events, and she's off the blocks now, nearly a second ahead. China over Brazil with Italy in third. Zhang Yufei in the pool for China. Fernanda Gomes Celidonio is in the pool for Brazil. Anita Gastaldi is in the pool for Italy, and making up ground. Poland have fallen by the wayside, but making up ground, going in lane three. Oh, Japan, after Yamamoto brought it back a little for the Japanese. Matsumoto is trying to swim fast and catch up on Brazil, who are over two seconds off the pace at the moment. Zhang Yufei is not going to be caught. China are going to conclude day five on an absolute high. Zhang Yufei is going to claim yet another gold medal. It's Italy who, through Gastaldi, are completely securing the silver. The battle for bronze should be Brazil, but it's China for the win and the new FISU record. Italy touch for silver, Brazil take bronze. China have dominated in the pool, but Zhang Yufei is doing something extraordinary. She is undoubtedly one of the swimming greats, and there's plenty of her career still to come. Seven gold medals in seven events for Zhang Yufei, who is tapering after the World Athletics Championships. That is astonishing. All eight teams went out male swimmer, and came home female swimmer, female swimmer. But the results convincing. China from lane two, champions in FISU record time, 3:25.38. 3:26.75 for Italy. Brazil take bronze, Italy take silver, and gold to People's Republic of China. Chen Junhe, Lin Tao, Li Bingjie, and Zhang Yufei, who's got seven golds now in seven events.